Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Alberta News and Views. I hope that all of you out there are doing okay in this crazy, crazy land, the Great White North, Canada, the upside down. Check this out. This from the National Post. Niagara region declares a state of emergency to prepare for solar eclipse crowds. Seriously, they call a state of emergency for crowds. Local authorities are expecting over a million people to go to the Niagara region, Niagara Falls, to stare at the sky, so they need a state of emergency. They need to call that. And it was for your safety. They're worried about critical infrastructure, the flow of traffic. I don't know. This is just crazy to me. To me, this just shows how government still views people as peasants, as like a herd of cattle running around all crazy, and they need to just control them all the time. And it just shows a complete disregard for the severity of a situation that you would need to call a state of emergency. Like, they're going to just start dropping these all the time now. It gives them total control to do whatever they want in however amount of time that they declare. It's not an emergency. It's people showing up to stare at the sky. It's absolutely ridiculous. I got a few other things I got to show you. For all of you out there that don't know, Justin Trudeau is a baptized Catholic. There's like over 19 million Catholics, Christians in Canada. Now, you would think that the Prime Minister, being baptized Catholic at all, would acknowledge Good Friday. Of course, Justin Trudeau did not do that, did the opposite. His last post on Twitter X, though, was talking about Ramadan. He says, "This Ramadan comes at an anxious time for the Muslim and Arab community. When I joined them for their iftar, I hope I'm saying that right, in Vancouver, I heard their worries firsthand about family and friends in Gaza and about feeling vulnerable here at home. And I let them know they are supported." So Justin Trudeau is a Catholic. I believe we're at over 20 churches burned down in Canada now, and he has said nothing about that. And he says nothing about Good Friday. I think that Justin Trudeau is truly compromised. And now, right now, he is just an empty shell of a man that has lost everything. And his masks are falling off at a record pace. He's not a politician anymore. He is not a man for the people anymore. He has lost his faith. He is not a family man. He's lost Sophie. And now he has just accepted too many brown envelopes, and he is just there to fulfill his end of the deal so he does not get blackmailed. I think that's what it is. The carbon tax, here's another good example. The carbon tax comes into effect April 1st. If it truly was about the environment, if he actually cared about the environment, he would have went after this coal issue long ago. It's the same thing with this home heating oil, the hypocrisy with that in Atlantic provinces. They get the carbon tax rebate, free heat pump, all that bullshit. And he says it's because home heating oil is just so toxic, releases so many emissions, so inefficient, blah, blah, blah. There is coal. If he cared about the environment, he would have instantly ended this coal. In British Columbia, by the way. NDP, Green, British Columbia. Canada's coal exports up again in 2023 as government's promised ban elusive. Canadian thermal coal exports reached its highest level in almost a decade in 2023, totaling 19.5 million tons. According to Ports of Vancouver and Prince Rupert, the International Energy Agency predicts that thermal coal demand may have peaked in 2023, with China and India being major users. It's just going to get cranked up. Demand is going to go up. China keeps on building coal-fired power plants. The hypocrisy is just unbelievable. Majority of Canada's coal exports comes from the United States, with 20% increase since the pledge to end thermal coal exports by 2030. Ending on that, I hope that all of you out there realize that British Columbia dumps raw sewage into the ocean, cuts down old-growth forests, and I'm talking rainforest trees. 1,000-plus-year-old trees, British Columbia is hacking those babies down. And they are exporting coal. at record pace. British Columbia is everything but green. Always remember that. It is really easy to pick on Alberta with our coal, which we barely do compared to them. We are branded oil and gas, of course. We're proud of it. We don't hide it. Unlike British Columbia, that does a great job of hiding all of their skeletons in their environmental closet. Alberta is the best at green tech and reclamation. You look at a coal mine before and after, and they usually start mining coal in areas that are uninhabitable anyway. That's what it's like over in Alberta. And then after, it's green. The reclamation is truly incredible. And these are environmental stories that need to be told about Alberta in what we do. I don't know about other provinces. I don't care. All I'm saying is British Columbia, to me, is the poster child for this green movement. Now, on the top, on the surface of it, you get someone like Justin Trudeau and that the David Eby, the NDP premier in British Columbia. On the surface, you have them standing with these beautiful trees and stuff, and oh, it's so beautiful in British Columbia. They never say anything about their environmental impact. It is unbelievable. It truly is. Alberta needs to start talking about how we have so much growth in the last 100 years and start saying that we demand credits for that growth and sustainability and reclamation. We want credit for that. Instead, they just say, tax me, tax me, tax me, and we're going to lower emissions. Canada's net zero already. We don't need to do anything, especially in Alberta. We're done. We did our part. We're good. We're not doing anything anymore. We're done. We did our part. If we didn't exist, nothing would change. We have to start doing things to other people now. Get them. Shut down this coal. Follow me on Substack and Spotify. All of you out there, like, share, and take care.